Hi everybody, it's Deacon Megan here, coming to you for our week 4 prayer practices. Now I have to admit, these prayer practices for this week are probably 2 of my favorites. Do you know why? Well, I don't know about you, but a lot of people, when they think about prayer, they think that it has to be something very quiet and very calm and very reverent, meaning you got to be very proper. But really and truly, there's no directions or no specific way that we are told to pray. We've been given some guidance in our Bibles of ways that we can pray and suggestions of how we can pray. But there's nothing that says it has to be this way or that way. And so one of our prayer practices for this week is called a shouting prayer. I don't know about you, but I usually tend to be really quiet when I pray. I'll lay in my bed at night and pray, or we'll pray together over the dinner table, or we'll say prayers at night when it's Susanna and Emma's bedtime. Those are some of the ways, and usually those aren't times where we're being really loud and noisy. But one of the prayers that's listed for us this week is called the shouting prayer. So you can pray and you can say, "I love you, God," at the top of your lungs. You can do it outside. I have a little one that's sleeping right now, so I'm not going to say it at the top of my lungs because I don't want to wake her up. But what the prayer of a shouting prayer tells us is you don't have to use a particular quiet voice. You can talk in a very loud voice. So I want you to try this one out this week. The next time you're out somewhere, to shout as loud as you can a prayer. Maybe you say, "Thank you, God." Or maybe you say, "I love me, God. Thank you so much for giving me health. Thank you, God, for a good family." Think about what you might say, and you can shout those prayers out loud at the top of your lungs the next time you think about praying. The other prayer that I absolutely love that's in our prayer practices this week is called the Nature Prayer Walk. This is a simple walk that has pictures that correspond and images and things that correspond with different topics to pray for. And so the first one is a bird that you can pray for someone who is important to you. You see a flower to pray for those who care for others. For an evergreen tree, you pray for leaders. For grass or snow or sand, depending on where you are, you may not have a bunch of grass. Pray for teachers. When you see leaves, you pray for your family. Or when you see a bug, you pray for whatever you choose to pray for. Then you can look, what else do you see in nature? That's the very last thing. So maybe you don't see all of these things. When we did our prayer walk this week, we saw every single one of these items on this list. And so each time, and actually we saw multiple, and so each time we would see a new one, we would say another prayer about that particular person. So you can use it as a checklist, or you can go through it over and over again and pray for different people as you come across those things on your walk. It doesn't have to be these specific things. They're just some ideas and suggestions to get those juices flowing for you about how you can pray in lots of fun and creative and different ways. Thank you, God, for this gift of prayer. Thank you, God, for these children and families who are watching these videos and learning along with us about how to pray and how to grow more closely with you and to you in this season of Lent. May God bless you and keep you and be with you until we meet again. Amen.